Hey, this is Ann Klemmer, and I'm here with Domino from StamperDog.com. Hey, I'm a crafter, and you don't have to be a crafter because we are going to be showing you quick and easy ways to make gift tags, whether you've got all the supplies to make everything really fancy, or you're just working with scissors and cardstock. Hey, let's get started.
Stamper, come.
Hey, we got North Carolina and Texas in the house. Hey, you know what? And thank you for your Christmas cards I've been getting. I'm going to show them to you. We're going to do maybe a little bit of sneak peek. We're going to show, a kit and some stuff you can do with your cut and emboss machine or your die cutting machine, whatever you have, and what you can make with just scissors and cardstock. Yeah, well, of course, we're gonna step it up just a little bit, but hey, let's get started on the mail. Happy mail. This is one of our kits, and I was so happy to get it from Eileen. Yeah, because she's new to stamping, and so she took these couple of these kits down to visit her friend in Colorado, and they made cards together, and I think that's great. You know, you could do that. Get together with your friends and that don't craft and introduce them to, you know, something new to do. And, you know, I'll get into that in a minute. But anyway, look at, and then this is one that my very first client made for me. Yeah. Yep. This is one of our old punches. Do you remember? Yeah. And then Kay sent me this, just got this today. No. Yesterday? No, today. Today. Yeah. So there you go. How much do you have your Christmas cards out yet? I do not. No. Because I spent all my time sharing them with you. Oh, look at that. All I know is Marcy's cookies are on their way to me. And all is well with the world. Yeah. So today, let me get out of here real quick. Today is the last day that you can get in for Thursday's play day. And I know Susan and Deb are going to be there. Are you going to be there? Because, you know, we make cards together with things that you have on hand, right? And then we may play a couple games, which shall remain nameless, right? I found this. I've been wanting to show this to you for a while. Isn't he cute? Does he make... I know he must make a noise. No, he doesn't. Wait. Nope. No, he doesn't make a noise. I got him on one of the cruises we were on, and I got him just because I went, I know where I can use that. Anyway, yeah, we do a couple things. Oh, Beverly's here. She's going to be there too. Yeah. So anyway, yeah, and so today's the last day that you can get in. We're giving away at least $120 worth of your choice of prizes. And, you know, here's the thing that is really exciting. The same day, Stampin' Up! Is going to be doing free shipping. Now, you know, they got really backed up on the first because they had, it was like the biggest sales day of all year, right? Because we had... For demonstrators, we had the pre-order of the new mini catalog that's starting in January. We had celebration early, for the demonstrators, right? So that we could get the stuff, and I'm going to show you some of the stuff, right? And then we had the clearance rack refresh. We had, well, anyway, there were four things, oh, yes. And then the last chance list, right? So what they're going to do, you can't get it by Christmas. And I'm not saying you can't. They just can't guarantee it by Christmas. Because if you live in a two-day shipping zone, and they should be caught up by Friday, right? They're planning on being caught up. But this was already planned, and they did not want to disappoint. So what we're going to do for those people who, are playing at the Stamp and Play Day and you win something, we'll get in on the free shipping because we'll close it that night. Okay. And I went, when I said okay, that was O-H-K-A-Y. Because, Kay, I showed your card and now I've put it down and I don't know where it is. So watch it on the replay. Okay? Got it. Now that was O-K-A-Y. Okay. Yeah, not O-H. Yeah. So anyway, there you go. So I hope that you will hang out with us because it is a fun day. And some of our viewers here that are here right now, they can tell you it is fun. And it's even more fun when you win something. And like, it's a really high win percentage. Yeah. So anyway, we're going to talk about how to make gift tags for your presents. And we've got a couple different options here. The question is, where did I put them just before we started? Beverly's talking about this. This is what's really funny. I'm going to tell you what, it was the biggest sales day this year, but more important from the shipping part of it, because there were so many things discounted on the last chance list and the clearance rack refresh, there were so many things discounted that the item count was, it's like, okay, we had a great sales day, but this is how many items we sold, right? And so those things all have to be put in the box. And I've actually worked the pick line. And believe me, if you want to lose weight, go to work at Stampin' Up! In the Riverton headquarters and go and work that pick line. Because one of the ladies even told me, yeah, I lost like, I forget, it could have been 10, 20 pounds. She lost a ton of weight just working the pick line because they've got it all padded. Not like where I stand here, but they've got it all padded, right? Where you're running up and down and the lights light up and then they have to take the amount that it says, like if you bought two of something, it'll say two. They have to pull two, throw it in the box. The box ships off to another section. It's really fascinating. It's very fascinating. But I've worked it for 10 minutes and that was fun. I worked for 30 minutes and I'm like, oh, I'm so glad I don't have to do this for a living. But if you want to get in shape, I'm sure they're hiring temps. Yeah, see, look at Deb will tell you. By the way, Deb, you asked me about a special dye. I found it. That can happen. That can happen. Okay, so I have this open. Let's start with one of the sneak peeks. Yes, I can't show it to you, like, because see it there. It stands up like this, and you put your blender brushes in there, right? And I wonder, I think it'd be hard to get two, but let's take a look. Nope, yeah, two don't fit in there, but see, look at how nice they are. You have to make sure you hit that little hole down at the bottom. There you go. So there's that, but it's not just that. Hold on. I put all the stuff, the new stuff in. Look at, they have mini blender brushes. So if the ones are too big, there you go. The minis, don't ask me prices because I'm lucky I can remember where my pants are, okay? In fact, I do ask for it. I have a special pair. I call them my show pants. There, see? And this is, if you want to see how they compare, see the heads are just, it's the same beautiful bristles. Whoa, there you go. Same beautiful bristles, but smaller heads. Now, why would you think that you would need a smaller brush? Why don't you tell me? I can figure it out. Believe me, I can figure it out. I can figure it out. But what do you think about that? Look at Beverly said, yeah, they're really a good size for doing a card. See, and Kay says the same thing. Now, these two tell you that they want to, okay, put them on your list. And then the holder, I'm going to tell you that I added a, because I bought a lot of blends at the end of September, I now have more blends. So I added another section to my, to where I keep my blends and my stamp pads and stuff. And you might be able to see, it's right there. See? And then I need more, but anyway, here's where the lamp is. And right underneath that, I have the, I know it's little. Okay. There you go. And I'm sorry it's not in focus, but I'd have to go back here. And then you'd see what the mess really is. It's actually better than it was. But anyway, that's where the skin tones are. And then my extras are going to go here because I have them. They're all underneath down at the bottom. And they're so that all of the brights, pads, and markers, and down at the bottom are the blends. And it's really great that you can go and... you know, that you can go and stack those organizational pods together any way that you want to. Yeah, I just love it. And see, look at, see, Deb said smaller area to blend, but here's a specific answer about why you want to have these itty bitty ones, right? Yeah. Yeah. So there you go. There's one sneak peek. Now, we have sweet treats coming up. So you might as well take a look at, is this gorgeous? Is that gorgeous? Yes. This is Favored Flower Designs. I have not played with any of this stuff. Well, I have Stamp Club tonight, so they're going to want to see this. So, yeah. I have one person that has got, that I've sent their, well, no, yeah. Plus my helpers that I've sent the new catalog to. But it's always nice to see these. Okay, here's one side. Here's the flip side. This is gorgeous. In fact, here's funny. This peachy color, that was the color. Oh, sorry. They see these lines drive the camera nuts. That was the color of our wedding. It was just me, Cecil, and the maid of honor, and the best man. This is gorgeous too. Yeah, I'm loving this. See, Deb is a really, you know, I don't know what the right word is, but she's got good taste. She wants it all. See now, and this is more of a muted color, which, you know, muted colors are not my thing as far as clothing. I prefer bright colors. In fact, I'm getting ready for the t-shirt fashion show. I love this one. I'm getting ready for the t-shirt fashion show in a minute. It's not my color red, but I liked what it looked like. So I said, okay, whoa. So yeah, what the sweet treats are, you get a 4x6 piece of all of the designer series papers that are coming out in the new catalog. Yeah. And you get a sample of all the embellishments, and you know, you can buy just the embellishments and ribbons. Now, I don't think I do it that way anymore because people either get it all or they just get the paper. So you can pick for where you get everything, you know, everything that we can split up. If they can't split it up, it doesn't work, right? But anyway, you can get, you know, like all a yard of each ribbon, a usable piece of designer, because then if you had a 4x6 piece of each one of these sheets, then you would, or at least each one of these patterns, then you'd know if you wanted to get more, right? Yeah. Yeah. Because you don't want to be overloaded with too much small stuff, right? Okay. So there's that. Anyway, as soon as we do the math, it's a huge spreadsheet and it's a labor of love. That's all I got to say. Okay. Celebration. Is this one of them? I'm not sure. No, this is not. This is from the Country Floral Lane. This is what this is called. I bought this suite. And what's cool is if you join my team now, you can go and you can include this stuff in your starter kit. Yeah, I'll give it to you now. Pastellies. Ooh, see, peach must be gonna be a popular color. I can remember when we were looking for dresses for my maid of honor to wear, because we just had a small wedding. There were 35 people there, and I was related to 28 of them, and we went all over looking for a wedding gown and a dress for her, and at one point she went, "This is peach." I went, "No, that's pink." It's peach. Well, you know, the bride's always right. So, but we got her dress on a clearance rack, right? And I got such a deal. Thank you to my then sister-in-law, who got me a great deal on my wedding dress. I love this. This is great. My wedding dress and my veil. And it was like $129. You have to remember this 40 years ago. But whatever it was cheap for what, you know, inexpensive for what it was. But my sister-in-law worked at she was a visual merchandiser. In other words, she designed the windows, right? And she's very artistic. Anyway, and so she went and got, like, the veil was less than cost. It was such a great deal. It was like a wedding put together on Band-Aids, and we loved it because we had 35 of the closest people there. And, you know, weddings don't have to be big and expensive. We just threw it ourselves, and it was where a lot of people helped, and we appreciate that. Yes, thank you. I'm glad you like that. Yeah, the flower. Yep. So anyway, that's some of the stuff. Let me see if there's anything else over here. Anything else? Oh. I've got glimmer paper. I've got some animal stuff. This is the iridescent pastel gems. See, we like to see these. Then we know how we're going to cut it up. So, yeah. So you would get like a strip of that and a strip of that, right? So this would get, that's for, sweet treats. And people keep buying them. So, you know, yeah. Yeah. Beverly's talking about, yeah. But you know what? Beverly's talking about her, I don't think she's talking about her waist, but don't we all wish, she's talking about her wedding too. Yeah. You know, and all that matters is that it works. Don't want to start off in debt. Unless you're spending that to go to Bali. Oh, my God. Oh, this is right. See, one's smaller and the other's bigger. And these are very pretty. I don't see, this is kind of like opalescent, you know. It's hard to really capture it on the camera. It's very, very nice. Yeah, it's, if you haven't seen on Peacock, Ticket to Paradise, I highly recommend. If you like romantic comedies, Julia Roberts and George Clooney, yes. You know what's going to happen pretty much, because it's, you know, there is no unique, computation, you know, formula. Yeah. There is no unique formula to rom-coms. Yeah, they all do. But it's just awesome. We really enjoyed it. In fact, I liked it so much. I watched it by myself, and then I watched it the next night with my husband. Oh, wow. Holy moly. Ours was in front of a church that we went to for a while, and then we found another church. Yeah. Yeah. So anyway, okay. So let's find this. Hold on. I do have a couple of these. It would make all these boxes look alike. Hold on. Hold on. You'd think I would have put these, but I have several of these, and because shipping's behind, if you need one of these, you just contact me after we're over, and see, look at, I have one of these. This has not been used. It's brand new. If you need for some last minute Christmas cards, I've just opened it and I showed you her card. Oh, look at Kay. Guess what? Here's your card. There's Kay's card. And here is that kit card. You make these with this kit. So if you just need something at the very minute, last minute, but then here's the deluxe version. Yeah, just drop me a line. I also have, one of these, some of these. So if you wanted some, except for this part right here, that's added in. Everything else is in the kit. This part's added in right there. Yeah, there you go. Okay, let me find my tags. You'd think I would have put them here, but I did not. Got them open. Well, I did. I did, but I have several boxes. Nope, not that one. Oh, and Clemmer, I'm not going to open an extra box because there it is. Yes, this is one, and I do have a couple of these. And we wouldn't have to wait until Stampin' Up! Gets them to you, but this is how they come. But I'm sure that there's one of these in there. This is called Christmas Gifting. We're going to be doing this with our Stamp Club tonight. Just as something so that they know. Oh, golly. See, I told you it was in there. There it is right there. So, yeah, I have brand new, because these are things that Stampin' Up! Will let us, carry. And I thought, oh, great. So we're going to show you three different ways to do tags. This is one. Just so you know how it works when you just first get it. Comes in that box. Then here are the instructions. You can make it any way you want. See, here's number one. 1, 2, 3. Here's the supplies. Everything for card one. Tag one, tag two, tag three. I think you make three of each one. This shows everything that's in here. I mean, there's such a deal. So let's go in. The only thing you don't get in here is, boy, I wanted to make this red one, but wow. Okay, we want this. 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 Just be very gentle. Oh, good. I'm glad this one you like, because that's what I'm going to do. Let's see. Make sure we're. It's awfully quiet over there in YouTube. The thing with these, just be very gentle when you when you do this stuff that has, you know, lots of little fine parts, just because you can't just rip that bad boy out of there because it's just not made like that. There you go. Ha, 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 look, this just pops out. Just, yeah, squeeze it back and forth. Are they letting you comment over there on YouTube? Because we're on... Okay, so I'm sure we could save this for something else. Yeah. Now, they have little glue dots for this, and that would be a no for me. I'm just... I can make it different. We have here. You can make it different, but you know, the first time out, I like to make it the way they intend it the first time, and then whatever's left over after me making everything the way they suggest it the first time, after that I go and you can put them all together any way you want. Like they say, just for you on this. See, Merry Christmas will fit on there. From our home to yours will fit on there. Just for you, of course. Merry Christmas. See, a lot of them, it's like... Now, this comes with shaded spruce. Ooh, there. Hold on. There you go. Shaded spruce. I have that open, so... You can still get, you know, you can get these from me, or you can get them, order them out of our online store for, to use for next year, because it's, you know, it's too late to get it guaranteed for this year. I just got ink on my finger. Now, I highly recommend that, you know, if you're new to this, the first time you stamp, go and stamp it on something else and, because virgin, sorry, virgin stamps are not, don't stamp the same as seasoned stamps, but that's still not bad. I'll take it. No, I just got a little bit on here, so I can just wipe it off on some paper here. It's just a little bit. Yes, and those of you who were concerned about my nail, yes, I broke a nail trying to get the dies off. Oh, golly. Now, in this, they tell you to use the dimensionals. Hold on, I've got some. Dimensionals are right in here. They're just a little different than the ones we have. But they're still good. I notice that they're a little bit, the tops are a little bit slicker. You know, and even people who stamp all the time and make cards all the time, kits are nice to have around if you need something quick and you don't want to think about it. See, now they have a circle on the back here for the two from. I just washed my blocks, so I should just go in. There you go. I'm going to follow my own advice this time. There, I stamped it once off camera. See if it goes any better. Oh, I see that. There we go. See, it's okay to go and stamp upside down. They show it up here. See, this is so that you could put a gift card in here. And don't be concerned that this gift card from Stampin' Up! Has been well used a long time ago. So, yeah. If you want to, you could put it up here. You could put it down here. There's nothing saying that you have to do it exactly the way they say. I'm using the extra stick over here. You can use what's in the kit. But these kits, there you go. And then look at you, don't even, come on, there you go. You just give it to them like this, right? Hang it from the tree. Isn't that nice? And then tie it together with that. What do you think? Marcy's got a good idea here. There you go. You know, Christmas is the same time every year, right? Christmas is the same time every year. Why is it that we get ourselves into this? Yeah. Now, how they did it. And I'm going to go from the other end. Let's see if I'm going to tie it the way they did. You can put you could attach it to it too. I mean, they don't say. It'd be nice if I put, yeah. I was holding it to where it was. How about if I just do one at a time? You think that'll work better? Yeah, I'm pretty sure. I saw something about threading a needle on top of a, I'm looking at black through this hole. That's why I can't see it. Now how they did it, right? It's like this, right? Right this. And then they just held these two together. And tied a knot right there. Let me pull it around that way. That'll make more sense. There. See, and then it just hangs. You tie it on. You put a personal note in there or what? Polly, this is from the Christmas giftings, and I have some of these, so if you want it, you know, I can ship it to you tomorrow, or that's just assuming that, yeah, in other words, as soon as I get paid, there it is. And then see, look at, there's other pieces, and it makes three different tags, and they hold gift cards on the back too. So I mean, this would be like your deluxe. You know, I even have one of those dental floss things, you know, somewhere. Oh, hello. Yeah, there you go. It's a good idea for me to look in the camera every now and then. What am I showing them? I don't know. Let me try to keep all this together because we're going to be playing with this tonight. And, you know, the kits come and go. So remember that we've got free shipping on Thursday. And that is for items that are, when you spend $75 or more. So there. Yeah. Okay. So. Back to this. Okay, so I told you I showed you three different ideas. This, I used the scalloped. Hold on, I put the dies off to the side. You'd think I would remember. Contour scallop dies, right? And I took two of them. I believe this is the third largest one. I'm going to take that. This is just easy, right? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's all I'm gonna do. No, I think 4. Okay. I bought myself a new stamp cleaner and I don't even know where I put it. I'm going, oh. That's why I have started cleaning a little bit. By the way, last I looked, if you don't have these, you have a die cutting machine and you don't have these. This is the Playful Alphabet dies. And these are on sale. And that's a good thing to have. Polly, I'd have to look it up, but I believe it's $21 before the shipping and stuff. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4. I think I'm going to do 4. I can always cut another one off, right? And I'm just going to try and line those up. Cut them. See how that's going to be right there? Yeah. Now, I highly recommend tear and tape for this only because, you know, you're trying to hold something in there. The seal and glue are great, but when you're pulling against it, you know, you're putting some kind of pressure up against it. Yeah. This all the way around. Y'all are gonna laugh when I show you what else. Yeah, it'd be nice if I didn't do that. Now, granted, you could run this through and put a nice little, that's what I would do, put a nice little different texture on the front. That would be nice. This is just what I think this took about a half a sheet of cardstock. Yeah. And then I'm just going to hold these together like this. There. And you could do decorative scissors here. You could decorate the front. I just went and bought me a little one of these because I don't know what I did with my old Stampin' Up one and we don't carry them anymore. And put this little office punch. See, if you just went along this, put the tear and tape just as close as you can to this little dip right here. This will be able to go in here and we'll decorate the next one and you'll see how you could use it. I know the red satin die, The red satin ribbon was on special. That's what I would use. This is just happened to be what I think. Eight inches is really primo for me to do this. I think I did it less than that this time, so it's going to be a little bit more of a challenge. 8 inches is usually my sweet spot. But then, ha! Wrong answer, Anne. Pay attention. I always tell myself, stick it in the back, right? Fold it, right? Stick it in the back. Pull these through here. And then the knot will always be on the right side, because this is the side that looks pretty. Do a few little snip snips. Ha! I cut myself. Cecil, I need a Band-Aid, please. You saw that happening. Yes, the edge dies would work well. And now that Nancy's here, we can do, and I'm bleeding. We can do the t-shirt fashion show. Yes. I told you this wasn't my color red, but hey, I liked what it said. Yes. I like the Mickey Mouse ones.
Okay. Here you go. Good name.
He gave me a tissue. I thought my spit worked rather well. Those are, yeah, maybe that's why we don't carry those ribbon scissors anymore. But hold on, because I've got the stuff here. Okay, you might remember this card that we did, right? You might remember this card that we did. Hold on, I've got to bring it out now. That's not the one. Here it is. Hold on. Oh, golly. Well, I know I'm not giving this card out now because I think I bled on it. Yeah, I did. Oh. Okay, remember this? Yeah, I bled on it now. So if you get this one in the mail, you know. It's very suspect. Hold on one second. This is bleeding more than I thought. I don't know what we did here, but this is really kind of like major surgery here. Boy, I saw myself. I knew I was going to do that too. Yeah, I guess we'll be throwing this card out. I don't know what happened to this.
Another one?
Yeah, because look at this. The it stuck to it. We got some brand new ones recently. Okay, well, it'll work. Okay, how about that? There's Mickey Mouse in here. Because I'm like, when people know if you have a... You're not hiding anything. Okay, this is how you open it. Hold on. Let me see if that makes a difference. Okay, now we got a Minnie Mouse one, and of course that one would work. Oh, honey, Kay Phipps is asking if I need a nurse. I can show my finger now that it, okay, this, now it's fine. I can show my finger because it's not bleeding, and I know some people don't like blood, so. I'm always thinking of you. Let's see, where to cut it. Now I can't even see where I cut it. Okay, now I see where I cut it. I used my vampire qualities. There we go. Leave it to the woman. Minnie Mouse did it. Anyway, I like to wear Mickey Mouse ones only because they... You know you've got a... You know you've got a Band-Aid on anyway. Oh, okay, so I kept this plain. You could texturize just the front, right? And for, so if you have a die cutting machine, this is great. But remember this card, and remember I'm going to be throwing that away now. But see, look at here we have, this is why I made it gray, because I never did attach those, and now it's going in the garbage. Okay. But see, look at, and his little blue hat matches the Visa card. My hair doesn't, but, or you could probably do it this way. Yeah, there you go. Okay, so now we're going to do the version with just scissors and cardstock. This is 2 3/4 inches wide, right? And I did this because, like that Celebrate, it's 8.5 this way. There's still lots of tags that are available, but you know, unless you pay for second day air, you're not going to get it before Christmas. But this is good to have on hand all the time, and then you don't have to figure things out. But this is tailor-made tags, right? 1 5 5 5, that's 3 5s. Okay, 6 3. This is seasonal labels. This could work out too. You just go and, you know, look at this size, but this size is too small for a gift card, but I think there's other sizes in there. And then see, this is the designer tags dies. And this, you have cutouts you can put with roses. It works for a lot of things, but this is like, if you don't have any, all that stuff, because remember, we all started somewhere. I can remember when I first bought my first die cutting machine. It's only because Stampin' Up! Had it. Okay, all the nurses are coming out. Yeah, I have more Band-Aids. So anyway, okay, so this is 2 3/4 by 8.5, right? And I'm going to score it at, I think I decided at 3 inches. I could do 3 1/4, right? Could do 3 1/4. Now this is the cutting one. That's why I put this on here, so I know which one. It makes me think. And I could make that fancy. But hey, this is for if you just need something right away. No, I should have done 3. I should have, but that's okay. That's okay. Then I'm going to take my paper snips. See, Kay says she likes the tag cut dies, and then she likes those designer tag dies too. Okay, so you don't have to take paper snips here. For this one, I think the best thing to do is this, because you can tell about what a 45 degree angle is, right? Kind of close, kind of sort of. So the first cut, see, I've got this on 2 3/4 and that on, well, it says 10.5, but that's coming from this direction, so that doesn't, yeah. Anyway, close enough, right? This is for if you want to teach your kids how to do this, yeah. This will get it close, won't be perfect. So things in life ever are. Now, if you really want to do this right, go and use your a glue dot and put those together, because you're just going to cut it off anyway. I stabbed myself with those scissors. Now you can see why my mother never let me play with knives. Okay, how's that? Not bad, right? Let's just hope we get this in the middle. There you go. Yes, Kay sells her tags. Yeah, people line up to buy case tags. They are not like what I'm showing you. I'm showing you the basics just to go and get her done. I hope that there's enough on here. See, on this one, yes, I should have done that lower because I was thinking I would be putting, let me look. Yeah, see, this is a little bit too low. And so instead of 3 1/4, I would do 3 inches, right? But since I didn't, if you ever cut it too low, all you need, hold on. All you need is to know where your small circle punch is, which I did have here. Hold on. And then I moved it. Then I moved it. So, hey, let's see. Hold on. Do I have a bigger one? I found something really nice, though, I'll tell you that. Oh, I found something pretty good, so it was all mint. See, look at, let's, you just go and find anything with a little dip in it. And hope. I could go farther in, that would probably be easier. Just anything with a little dip. I would normally use just a little circle. See? That'll work. See, now when I put it in here, it's easier for them to get out. I still go along with the tear and tape. Make sure you put this on the short side. Oh, that's great. That's the... Kay does a lot of stamping. Nope, this is the end of that one. That's okay, I've got more. Here it is, the one that I started off with. There you go. I love this stuff. I used to use this stuff instead of glue on my embossed, you know, when I would emboss something. And I made these gray because he had a gray beard. So that's why I made it gray. I knew I had changed it to, that I had said to go, told myself to fold it at 3. See, now that's a little bit snug. So I would go and do it like 1 7/8. 3 inches would be better. I'm just here to go and make the mistakes for you. And then, you know, decorate it however you want. There you go. Same idea, but if you don't have a die cutting machine, and there's nothing saying that you can't go off the edge. But like I said, oh, Polly, there's not just one adhesive for anything. You know, I like our, I like this, you know, this is the, Seal Plus, I like the seal. You know, some people don't. It demands to have a very light touch. But overall, the glue is great, but it just doesn't, it's not good for something like this because it's really strong. But something like this, no, I would, it's especially like if you're putting together a box, you know, you don't want to just be sitting there for 20 minutes. Well, it doesn't take that long to go and dry, but you don't want to forever. But I do like tear and tape for that. But mini glue dots have their spot to go and hold things to just small areas together. So I like a lot of different adhesives. I'm just a bit of an adhesive snob. If you want to know the truth, yes, I am. I admit it. I'm an adhesive snob. Yes. So anyway, yeah, that's my take on it. And remember that today is the last day you can get in and do our stamp and play day. Yeah. Because it's Thursday and we are going to have a lot of fun. We're giving away at least $120 worth of stuff. And yeah. So if you have any questions, bring them to me right now or drop me a line and just say hello. And if you're not getting my newsletter now, you really should be. And just go here to stamperdog.com/hello and get on there. And because every week we send you different card making ideas that you can use for your own card making. Hey, I am so glad that you came today. Do we have a dog around? Oh, my husband, he's eating. Oh, yes. See, look, I have some people endorsing it. Yeah, right here. Yeah. But make sure that you get, you know, go over to stamperdog.com/playday and then you'll be in on it. It's going to be fun. Ah. Oh, hold on. And the dog's going to have to say hello. Because this is the last time you're going to see him like this. Yes, this is the last time you're going to see him like this. He's going to look like a real Jack Russell, hopefully, next time. He won't look like a little... Yes, it's the mascot for the Stamp and Play Day. Oh, yeah. He's getting... going to the spa on Thursday. Oh, he burps, Cecil. What are you feeding him out there? Probably giving him, hey, your dog's calling. Yes, he's got his hoodie that doesn't go up. Anyway, he's like, no, get me off stage. There you go. Yeah, we went and we finally got our tree up. Do you have your tree up? We finally got a new angel. Oh, I'm so happy. And I'll be putting that over there in the dog pound. Anyway, I've gone a little bit longer than I had planned, but I hope you got something out of today. Remember, have a really Merry Christmas. I'll see you next Tuesday at 2. This is Ann Clemmer and Domino from StamperDog.com, where we put a little ink, paper, and fun.
Well, yes.
Into your day. Go make it a great day. Make a card. Mail it.